Hi, it's Binny here. Now today I'd like to share with you this trade which is on TVN. There's two things I want to talk about. Number one is the possible inverted head and shoulder right now that's forming in TVN. Let me just draw out the inverted head and shoulder here. And then we have also, if you can see this little tick here, right? So that's the buy signal coming in from Tor, which is the alien wash that I've designed. Now, we talk about the traditional use of a inverted head and shoulder, which is to buy when price close above the neckline. So this is the neckline that can draw here. So we probably are looking to buy at, for example, the start of this candle here. Okay, because then only at this candle that price show a little bit of a close above the neckline. Okay, however, to me, this kind of signal is a little bit too slow and it's probably also dangerous. Now, why is that so? When we are looking to buy at the break of the neckline, and it also depends on how we draw the neckline can be drawn based on the horizontal level here. So that's a horizontal level. However, if I were to take a little bit more and into the consideration of more price point, right, then there could be a potential where we have another one more horizontal level here. Okay, so therefore, if price is to close above the previous high, which I mark here at 1, right, immediately it might reach to the second high, which is this high here that I'm marking right now at 2. We might even get trapped here, because if we're going to buy when price breaks above 1, depending on where you bought in, you might immediately reach into the high of 2 and then it might come back down to result in a loss. Now these are possible things that's happening, because when we trade into an inverted head and shoulder, alright, the idea is we are buying on a possible reversal. So this means that we are potentially saying that this down move in Kiwi Yen might be coming to a pause because that it is showing an inverted head and shoulder pattern here. Alright, to me, what is a better way to trade that is to buy or try to buy somewhere near to the low. Okay, so somewhere around here. So isn't this a better idea? Because then if you can have a method to buy somewhere near to the low, but then at least you are able to capture this part of a profit, all right, all the way until the resistance. Okay, so this becomes like the first leg of a profit. Now if price really really can close above the resistance, then you're gonna have the next leg of profit, and that becomes more profitable. Now the second reason of why I think that it's safer to buy at the bottom here, that's because of the stop loss. Now therefore, if we can buy somewhere near to the bottom, let's say if I can buy somewhere near to the start of this candle, so this bullish candle here, at least I can control my stop loss, my risk, to be near to the low of the lowest low that I've seen right now. So this means that the first wave of reward to risk ratio will be a little bit healthier. So for example, if I can buy somewhere here, so these might be my risk, and then when it goes up to this high, so that becomes my possible reward. I know at this level the risk reward might not be a lot, but however, if price can move to the second leg of its going up, then we can see that potentially that risk would be quite nice in terms of the possible reward that you're gonna have. Alright, then how can we trade and buy at the bottom here, right, so that we can profit that initial stage up? Now this is where I design the wash and rinse. Let me just explain what is wash and rinse. Now wash and rinse is a method which trades on a fake break. That means that there are certain price level that makes it very lucrative for the market maker to artificially move price down or up to a certain price level that trapped or tricked a lot of traders, right? So for example, initially there was a support here, so that's the first support, we call that S1, right? Now then price moved down. At this point when price moved down, we realized that there was a close below the previous low. Alright, but when it moved down, it moved back into the price level of S1, right? And in fact, that at the second support level here, which I call the S2 is still showing a support, right? Now, if this is the case, then those people who traded the short side, that means that who sold, in this case, would be trapped because they think that by price moving lower, they think that price might be going down, but in fact that it is still supported. So what we do is that we label this candle as a wash, and then the subsequent candle that moved in the counter direction of the wash would be regarded as a rinse. Now this is the place where the wash and rinse happen. Let me just write that down for you. Wash and rinse. Now it's a very, very common phenomena, all right, where the market maker or the professional traders or the big players, right, they would artificially move price to a certain price point, which resulted in a temporary reversal of the original direction. But however, that temporary reversal is just a trick to trap people into a certain trade, but that's not what it's meant to be, right? So that's a trick. So once people are trapped and once the market maker have accumulated enough, then they will reverse price to move in the other direction. And usually after a wash and rinse happen, the subsequent price movement is usually explosive, as what we can see here. All right, now if you're interested to know more about wash and rinse, please go to my website, Online Forex Master, where you can attend the free module on wash and rinse, because I have created a module where I will be talking about how to identify wash and rinse and the different patterns of wash and rinse and how to increase the signal of a wash and rinse. All right. Now, this trade was alerted to me because there was an alert being sent. All right. So we are fortunate enough to receive the alert from the TOR indicator. So TOR indicator, part of the TOR indicator is this function called TOR dashboard. It will automatically send alert whenever a trade has confirmed in the lower time frame. Right. So lower time frame that we are trading right now is the 4-hourly. For the Forex, all right, and we are fortunate enough to enter a trade somewhere around here, all right, so that's where we have entered our trade. Now, this trade is currently doing very well because then at the point of entry to right now is about 85 pips, and it's coming into a horizontal level right now, as you can see a horizontal level right now, but we are up about 85 pips and we are going to shift to stop. The stop loss to break even, so that if in case this place is a resistance, for example, then at least we can still protect our trade, okay? Meaning that instead of buying on the breakout on the traditional way of an inverted hand shoulder, we choose to have an earlier entry with a tighter stop loss, all right, based on wash and rinse. Don't trade without getting educated. If you'd like to take my courses, I have two free courses here in the Online Master Forex. One of them is a basic course that allows you to know the basic of trading, such as, for example, support resistance, candle states, some of the important lines and some of the sentiments. Now, the other one is the Alien Wash course, which I've specially designed to trade into futures, into Forex, and into cryptos as well, and indexes. Alright, so the Alien Wash right now is free for Module 1. In Module 1, you're going to learn many things such as the wash and rinse phenomena and how to know that to trade the wash and rinse into different instruments, and why is it that the wash and rinse is often explosive after it happened. Alright, for Module 2 right now is 100% sponsored. Alright, meaning that the broker will pay for the course fee, that will reimburse the full course fee if you meet the very, very simple criteria. Now, do take this sponsor, because then it's a limited time and you're able to withdraw the amount of sponsored money as cash. Alright, hope to see you in my course.